So in 2007, you started working for yourself, and I don't understand. I want to know what the timeline with your struggle with addiction was over these years.
Oh man,
and how that overlays with, you know, how starting, you know, starting your own business.
So I literally got sober like right before I started my own business. So I was really struggling with my alcoholism the whole time I was working for my parents. And to be honest, like if I'd been working for anybody else, I would have been fired a million times over because I was a fucking mess, especially towards the end. I mean, I was drinking all the time. I was drinking in the morning just to stop the shakes. Like, I mean, like people have no idea how bad I got. I was able to sort of hide it. Yeah, but I was a mess. I mean, I drank on shoot. There was a couple shoots that I've done that I don't remember like at all. I completely blacked out. And you know, I had a lot of, I mean, my parents kind of covered for me. I think they had a really hard time dealing with it, and they didn't know, like, cause no one in my, I mean, my family's, there's definitely alcoholics in my family, but nobody's ever, there's no sober people in my family. I'm the only person who's ever been through recovery, and they really didn't know what to do.
Yeah.
I remember at one point my mom bought me a very fancy espresso machine because she thought if I drank more coffee, I'd drink less alcohol, or like I could sober myself up more. You know what I mean? Like
bless her heart.
Yeah. I mean, she just didn't know how to handle it. Mm-hmm. And I went to rehab twice. You know, so
did you go to cushy rehab or tough rehab?
I went to like middle of the road rehab. I didn't go to like Promises or anything like that. But it was nice, but it wasn't like we didn't like have yoga and a private chef or anything like that. But I also like didn't go to like prison rehab. So yeah. I went back to the same place twice. Actually.
Okay,
yeah. It was kind of funny because then when I first went, I refused to admit that I was an alcoholic. I was like, oh, I just need to like come here and like get my shit together, dry out, like, you know, takes 30 days off, like learn how to drink like a lady. And then I'll be fine. I'm not like the rest of you. And I just remember the counselors being like, you'll be back. And I'm like, no, I won't be back. I don't, you know, I'm not like you. I'm different. You know, it's like the cry of every alcoholic. And then, yeah, I remember actually, this is the scary thing about alcoholism is that it's the only disease that tells you you don't have a disease. And when I, so after my first stint out of rehab, I didn't drink for 3 months, right? But then my birthday came along and I was like, well, I have to drink on my birthday. I mean, everybody drinks on their birthday. Don't be ridiculous. And so I went out to dinner with my family. And I ordered a glass of wine. And my mom looked at me like, dude, we just fucking put you through rehab. Like, what are you doing? And I took her hand and I looked her in the eye and I meant every single word. And I said to her, I said, Mom, I promise you I will never drink like that again. I now know how to drink like a lady. I've like been to rehab. I've had all this therapy. And I promise you it's going to be different this time. And like, I fucking believed it. I really, really did. And then about 4 months later, I was back to exactly where I was before. And I was just like, how the fuck did I get here? Because that's the thing. Like before I really understood what alcoholism was, I thought that it was just something that people who were weak, people who had no willpower had, or people like, you know, who had a lot of trauma in their past or grew up, you know, in like a horrible impoverished environment, like people who had reasons to be alcoholics, right? Like I didn't have any reason. I had a great childhood. I had a family who loved me. I had friends who loved me. I had a great successful career. I had like everything going for me and I just couldn't stop. And it was the most frustrating thing in the world because I was just like, what the fuck is wrong with me? And I kept trying to think my way out of the disease. And I just couldn't do it. It's the strangest thing. It's impossible to explain to somebody who hasn't been through addiction, but it literally is just like this entity takes you over and you're not in control of yourself anymore.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's really crazy.
Absolutely. So you got sober around the time you started your own business. Would you say that your business is kind of an addiction? Because you work harder than anyone that I have ever seen. I feel like all the energy you put into drinking is now put into Holly Rand.
100%. Yeah. That's the problem with being like an addict is that like I always will be an addict in some way. It's just like, what do I transfer that addiction, that obsession to? And work absolutely became that obsession for me. Mm-hmm. You know, it was where I got my validation from. It made me feel good. And it's something that I definitely still struggle with. I still work like all the time. And lately I've kind of been in this place where I think to myself, I'm like, you know, and I think especially now with the internet and social media and all these different ways of monetizing, you know, our brand and mm-hmm. different things that we can do. And I'm, you know, I mean, anybody who knows me, I've got like 5,000 projects that I'm trying to juggle at one time. And I feel guilty if I'm not working all the time. Like if I take some time off, I feel like I should be doing something right now. And then I was trying to think to myself, I was like, what do I want? Like, what am I trying to achieve? Yeah. Where am I trying to go? And like, is this actually making me happy? Or is it just like creating more and more stress in my life?
What was the answer you came up with?
I don't know. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, make sure that you subscribe so you don't miss a single episode. And go check out all the other videos. I film every single one of my podcasts. And if you want to listen to the audio version, I'm on iTunes and all the other podcast platforms. Visit HollyRandallUnfiltered.com to find out more.